It's going really good. You know, I'm excited. I'm a little exhausted. You know, one thing the city manager reminded me of is that he didn't want me to work every day. He wanted me to take some time. I think I've taken one day off since I've been here, one Sunday. But by and large, 8 in the morning to about 9 o'clock at night, and it's been fun.
What's been the most challenging in these first 45 days?
Getting around and meeting the folks that I really do need to meet internally first. You know, I've been out and about. You know, my PIO, Julie Johnson, and others have made it a point to get me where I need to be. But at the same time, there are 1,000 men and women right here at CPD that I want to meet them as well. And I probably met about 2/3 personally so far. Well, the first observation I have is that the department has been very well run. I know this department has had some issues, you know, several years ago. I think they have corrected a lot of that. Clearly, there is a lot of good oversight here. That being said, there are some things that I'd like to do to put my stamp kind of on this CPD compared to the other CPD I worked at. And that has a lot to do with my platform in the community and my youth engagement. The kids that are not engaged in any type of nefarious behavior, not criminals, not bad kids, not doing anything wrong, they still have that chip on their shoulder when it comes to police officers. They still have that mistrust and that distaste in their mouth. They don't want to engage us. They don't want to talk to us. They're not friendly. If that's starting at that age, that only gets worse as they become adults. So we've got to do something to get in the way of that fractured relationship. And the first thing you do is you develop friendships with them. You let them know that we're not the enemy. And then you also have to have a very robust component of police officers that work with kids in a non-enforcement capacity. They can't always be seeing this uniform, because this uniform is threatening to some kids, especially black kids and Hispanic kids. This uniform represents oppression. A lot of police officers don't want to recognize that, but it's true. So we need to get past all of that and start to develop some good friendships. And we can do it.
And in line with the uniform, I mean, the uniform also commands respect, or it should command respect.
You're right.
And I would imagine you also want to say, look, it might be threatening to you, but you do have to still respect it.
That's right. Right. You respect that uniform, and that's why I brought the hats back. You know, Chief Craig felt, you know, his style was to be a little more relaxed. He cut his teeth in Los Angeles. They don't wear hats in L.A., partly because it's so daggone hot out in L.A., they don't wear hats. But he came here and relaxed that policy, and I brought that back because I firmly believe that this uniform needs to be worn a certain way to command the respect that you just spoke of. And I remind people in the community all the time, don't have a loss of memory. Have a memory of loss. And when you have a memory of loss, every one of them, every one of those boys who's died has a name, has a story, has a mom, sister, brother. They have a connection at some level in the community. We ought to respect that. And so in the black community especially, we have got to quit making excuses, and we've got to quit maximizing that fracture to the point where we won't call the police when we know something's going on, because we dislike the police more than we want to help solve crime. Even homicide, fratricide in our community is off the charts. To say that a young black boy, his number one chance of death in this country is through homicide, 80% of the time at the hands of another young male black, is preposterous. It's got to stop. And we're not going to be able to police this situation away. So my message is, until the pastors and the community people take note that they have a responsibility in this equation, they've got to help us. But I believe that fear is overblown. I really do. You know, in my own one of the high school I grew up near in Columbus, Lyndon McKinley High School, I was a keynote speaker a couple of years ago, and I asked all the kids to raise their hands if they've known a kid that's died in gang violence, and every hand went up. It's over 600 kids in the auditorium, every hand. I asked those that had their hands up to keep their hands up if they knew who had killed their friend, and about half the hands stayed up. I was shocked. So the last question was, of those hands that are still up, keep your hand up if you told the boy's mother who killed her son. And not one hand stayed up. So that right there is, it broke my heart to see that these kids who say, you know, this is my boy, this is my friend, I call his mom, he eats Cheerios at my house and I go to his house, and in death, they won't even go and do what's right and tell the boy's mother what happened. And they all know. So we have this huge group of mothers throughout this entire country. They've formed organizations and coalitions so that they can handle the grief. And 95% of those homicides could be solved if people just stood up and did the right thing. I didn't want to pass judgment originally. When I first got here, everyone was saying, you need more cops, you need more cops, you need more officers. And I've had a chance to kind of assess the department and our needs and what we're trying to accomplish. And we do need more people. We're dangerously short-staffed here at CPD. So I'm hopeful that the mayor-elect, Mayor Cranley, will find some money in the budget to give us a recruit class. We need one. We want to reduce violent crime. We want to get a grip on all the shootings in Cincinnati, some of the turf war, some of the gang violence that's going on. We want to get a grip on that a little better than we have. And then we want to really start to implement some of the initiatives that I have. You know, I want to bring the GREAT program in, the Gang Resistance Education and Training. I want to start midnight basketball. We're gonna re-energize the Cincinnati Police Athletic League. I just had a meeting today about that and get that back and make it as robust as it can be so we can invest in kids and fight crime at the same time. So it's going to be a challenging time as we go through lean manpower times, lean budgetary times, but our spirit is high here, and I think collectively we'll push through. We'll get it.